Sunny Southern California is actually a desert, and so we have to import our water from Northern California, Nevada, and in some cases even Colorado. So what if we could recycle some of our wastewater? The city of San Diego is doing just that with Pure Water San Diego. Here's a short clip of how it works.
The city has been operating a 1 million gallon per day demonstration pure water facility since June 2011. The city's water purification process includes five steps that work together to protect public health. The first step of the purification process is called ozonation. Ozone gas is infused into the recycled water, and the water travels through a long series of pipes called the ozone contactor. The ozone destroys microorganisms and reacts with and breaks down contaminants in the water. The ozone is consumed and is converted into oxygen prior to the next step. Next, the water goes through biological activated carbon filters. The filters are filled with helpful bacteria, which thrive in the presence of oxygen. The bacteria on the filters consume 30 to 50% of anything that is living or was living. The next step is membrane filtration. The membranes filter out particles, viruses, and bacteria in the water. Only water, salts, and other very small molecules can pass through the membrane pores and down the center of the straws. Imagine, these pores are 300 times narrower than a human hair. Next, the water goes through reverse osmosis. Using high-pressure pumps, water molecules are forced through spirally wound membranes. Reverse osmosis filters out additional materials, even those that are 50,000 times smaller than the smallest bacteria and viruses. Water is last sent through a process called ultraviolet disinfection. In these units, the power of ultraviolet light, similar to extremely concentrated sunlight, penetrates the water and destroys the DNA of any microbes and viruses that may be present. At the same time, advanced oxidation generates powerful reactive molecules that destroy any trace contaminants that might remain in the water. The result of this multi-barrier process is purified water. To date, more than 28,000 lab tests have confirmed that the purified water produced meets or exceeds all drinking water standards. By investing in the Pure Water program, we can ensure a safe, reliable, and sustainable water supply for generations to come. To learn more about Pure Water San Diego, visit purewatersd.org.
So, where do chemical engineers come into this process? Chemical engineers develop and refine all these processes. Let's explore how we would do that for the last part of the process called UV disinfection. Actually, we prefer to call it UV photocatalysis. UV disinfection is usually used to kill microbes.
My name is Sabine, and I am one of two engineers who keeps the chemical engineering undergrad lab running smoothly. James is the other engineer, and you will meet him in the video of the reverse osmosis. I wanted to show you briefly today the parts of the photocatalytic reactor experiment, and then we will show you a short video of the actual experiment that one of our students made a few years ago. So here's the overall setup of the photocatalytic reactor experiment. This big container here will contain the solution when we conduct the experiment, and this small container here in the front shows you what that solution looks like. We use a 10 parts per million solution of methylene blue dissolved in water. Here in the back, you have a pump with the controller in the front, and that pump will pump the solution through our actual reactor. And up here, this is the actual photocatalytic reactor. I've taken one of these photocatalytic reactors and I've opened it up to show you what's inside. In the back here, inside that clear glass tube, you can see something that looks like a pretty strange looking light bulb. That's the UV light bulb. And then here you see the housing, and then you see a spiral right next to it. And that spiral makes sure that the solution comes in good contact with the UV light during the reaction. And here in the back, we have a glass vial full of titanium dioxide, and the titanium dioxide is our catalyst for this reaction. And we add that to the photocatalytic reactor. The last important part of this experiment, we have to have a way to actually measure the concentration of the solutions. You can see we have three solutions there with different concentrations. And to measure the concentration, we measure the absorbance of the solution. We do that with this little spectrophotometer here. And you can see on the computer, there is an absorbance curve with different wavelength, and the absorbance maximum for this methylene blue solution is about 650 nanometer wavelength.
Cool, right? Just to recap, the blue solution is what we use to simulate the wastewater. The goal of this experiment is to optimize the process of treating the wastewater until it is clear. So, a while back one of our students made a pretty cool video of the experiment itself. Enjoy!
Empty the system and prepare a solution of the measured water volume with 10 parts per million methylene blue and 1000 parts per million titanium dioxide. Also add roughly 5 milliliters of 6% hydrogen peroxide to kickstart your reaction. Turn on the stirrer, plug in the UV lamp, and turn on the pump again to start cycling the solution. When the stirred solution has fully cycled through the system and reacted with the UV light, it is time to take a sample. Take off the cap and use a pipette to pull enough solution to fill two centrifuge tubes. Use a centrifuge to separate the precipitate from the solution. Turn on the power, open the cover, and place your samples. Make sure to balance the centrifuge by placing the tubes on opposite ends. Close the cover, turn the dial clockwise, and press the center dial button to start the centrifuge. The timer will not work on this particular centrifuge, so remember to keep track of time for about 1 to 2 minutes. After time is up, turn the dial all the way counterclockwise and wait for the cover to open. Use a pipette to transfer the supernatant and place it into a cuvette. You may need the supernatant from both centrifuge tubes to fill one cuvette. Place the cuvette inside the spectrophotometer. Make sure that the cuvette solution level is at or above the white rim so that it is properly read. Open up the software and click Collect. Look for the wavelength with the highest absorbance value. You will want to collect data with only the wavelength that has the highest absorbance value. Stop collecting data and click Configure Spectrometer. Set the collection mode to absorbance versus time and collect data on the wavelength with the highest absorbance value. The wavelength with the highest absorbance value should be pre-selected. Once you've collected enough data, click Stop and click Statistics to receive stats on your data. You can continue to collect more samples from your system and repeat the data collecting process.
So, what did we learn from this experiment?
Now that you've seen the video of the actual experiment, let's talk very briefly about the results of that experiment. We've seen those three solutions earlier, and the one on the left is the solution that we started with. The middle one is taken after about 10 minutes in the experiment, and then the one on the right is taken at the end of the experiment. And you can see that we have completely treated this wastewater, and it is now completely clear.
To optimize the UV photocatalysis process, we would of course have to conduct a whole series of these experiments. Thank you for watching.